In this video, I'm going to share how the Coverity development testing platform enables users to take advantage of IAST, or Interactive Application Security Testing, for web applications. This presentation assumes that you're familiar with the Coverity development testing platform and our analysis technologies. I'll start with a quick explanation of what IAST is, how Coverity helps, then demonstrate Coverity's capabilities on an example code base. First, a little background. The security and development teams both participate throughout the software lifecycle, both focused on their own objectives. They work together, of course, but that cooperation is not always smooth and efficient. IAST is an evolution of SAST and DAST that aims to correlate the results of different types of analysis to improve the quality and confidence of results. These tools are often used in the security process, as many organizations struggle to gain adoption in the development process. Coverity's solution leverages technologies including IAST to provide a deep understanding of your application's security exposure. It specifically addresses the needs of developers, ensuring adoption among the folks that write and fix the code where defects and vulnerabilities live. By providing accurate, detailed information about each issue, including the problem, which source lines contribute to the problem, and where and how the problem should be fixed, by maximizing accuracy and minimizing false positives, the Coverity solution enables developers to confidently address security problems without requiring security expertise. Architects and security management can influence the security and testing policies used by the platform, ensuring that security needs are addressed from beginning to end. You may have heard claims like this before, so let me show you how the Coverity development testing platform is able to deliver on the promise. I'm showing you a selection of results from analyzing the OWASP WebGoat exemplar project in the Coverity platform. In this view, you can see several different types of issues in the list of outstanding issues. Here at the top, we can see security problems, and further down, there are some quality issues like null dereference and resource leaks. If we open this issue, you'll see how easy it is for a developer to understand what to do. The messages clearly indicate that there's a cross-site scripting vulnerability in this JSP, where the unsanitized value returned from the getName method is inserted into a PC data context. It's possible, perhaps even likely, that a developer won't know what to do with that information. The yellow section below the report takes it a step further and recommends passing the data through the escape.html method to sanitize it for the appropriate context. This ensures that even developers without security training can fix this problem correctly. Our security advisor demo covers this in more detail. Suffice it to say that we're careful to recommend a specific sanitization sequence that will solve the problem for the appropriate context, even when there are multiple nested contexts. We even verify that the sanitization routines sufficiently sanitize for the contexts. As this issue was identified through static analysis, developers will probably want to do some research to verify that the report is not a false positive. You can see how the data flows through the application, from the session getters through the Java source to the JSP, and finally the HTTP response. In fact, as you're examining that data flow, you can also see that this issue has a second instance that was detected by the DAST analysis. In addition to presenting problems identified by different technologies in the same list, the platform automatically correlates different instances of the same problem to reduce false positives and provide developers with more confidence in the results. Because DAST detected that this issue is exploitable, the confidence was automatically raised to high. You may also notice how the issue has an assigned owner. That's another way that the platform helps developers manage issues. It can be configured to automatically and intelligently manage triage fields like owner, impact, or confidence as appropriate. In this case, new defects are initially assigned to the person that checked in the code which introduced the problem. In fact, the entire process from build through analysis, assignment, and even email alerts can be automated to ensure minimal impact on developer workflow and a closed loop for accountability. That's an example of how the Coverity platform correlates SAST and DAST results, increasing accuracy and confidence, and how it reports security issues in terms and context that are accessible to developers. Now I'd like to show you how other aspects of the platform can enable security and quality teams to influence the way that code is developed, even in the early stages. One of the limitations of DAST is that it can only report problems in code that it tests. When you get a clean DAST report, it's not always obvious what that actually means. Is everything clean? Or are there important areas of the application that were not tested? The Coverity platform can help you improve your confidence in your testing regimen, just like it can improve confidence in individual results. For example, Most web applications have an authentication system, and it makes sense to test the authentication system to verify that it is well tested and adheres to specifications. DAST in particular is often used to exercise the authentication code. This issue is reporting that there are untested lines in the authentication class. That's not necessarily a big deal in general classes, but you probably want to test everything in the authentication class to make sure you know exactly how well it's working. Our forward-thinking security team established a testing policy to ensure that they could verify whether authentication is working. They established a policy requiring 100% testing coverage of the authentication class. If everything is working correctly, no problems are reported. Otherwise, they'll get either a test failure when something isn't working correctly, or a policy violation if authentication code is not tested. This is an example of the latter case. The tests failed to exercise all the code, and we're seeing a violation in the platform. Note how easy it is to see which lines were and were not executed during the DAST analysis, in the red and green coverage bars to the left of the code. The platform actually provides sophisticated filtering capabilities to allow you to focus coverage requirements on the code that's interesting to you. More information is available in our Test Advisor video. In fact, this coverage information is available on an ongoing basis in the platform. You can even get a report of coverage by function to understand which areas of your application are not being exercised by DAST so that you can improve coverage and confidence in the results. For a higher level view of development policy compliance and to track these trends over time, the data in the platform feeds into Policy Manager, the Coverity governance and management interface. More information is available in our Policy Manager video. Thank you for taking the time to learn how the Coverity development testing platform can help you improve your product security. Our solution enables developers to easily identify and resolve quality and security problems in development. Security and quality stakeholders gain influence over and insight into the development process, ensuring that their needs are not an afterthought, but baked into the process. To learn more about complementary parts of the Coverity development testing platform, please view our videos about Security Advisor, Quality Advisor, Test Advisor, and Policy Manager.